Now, one among common challenges that we as water engineers face during the design of water supply networks is excessive pressure. Okay, now in this EPANET tutorial, we are going to learn how to deal with excessive pressure by using break pressure tanks. In short, we are going to learn how to model break pressure tanks in EPANET software. Again, if you are new here, my name is Engineer Lodrick, and this is Hydroinformatics Academy, a place where we discuss about technologies related to water supply networks. And if you are interested, just subscribe, turn on a notification. And that being said, I'll see you in the next part of this video. Okay, so this is our simple or a very basic water supply network. As you can see here, we have a source, which is a river, and here we have a destination. We are supposed to take from our source 3 liters per second and supply it to our destination. Remember, this is the point where people consume water. Okay, so this can be a water tap or anything similar to that. So far so good, our network is at least to some extent well optimized, because as you can see here, when you check velocities, we have 0.6. And again, when you check our unit head losses, you have 7 meters of head losses per 1 kilometer, again, which is not bad. But there is one thing here that we need to take it into account before we finalize our design. Remember, this is the point where people consume water. And this point, if you have this kind of pressure, this is not what you want, okay? This is the point where we expect at least to have maybe 1 to 2 bars of water, or 1 to 2 bars as pressure. Okay, but at this particular moment, we have 236. That is very big. So by any chance, we need to find a way to deal with this kind of pressure. Remember, there are several ways to deal with pressure in water distribution networks. And one of them, or the common one, is break pressure tanks. Okay, so this is what we are going to cover in this tutorial, as I said earlier. So again, there are several ways to model break pressure tanks in EPANET model, but for me and for this tutorial, I'm going to show you a very simple trick that you can use to model a break pressure tanks in EPANET. Now, this trick require you to have a pressure regulating valve. So we are going to use a pressure regulating valve as a way to model break pressure tanks in our EPANET model. Okay, now let me show you how to do it. Remember, here we have 66, which is not bad, but from this point here we have 123. Okay, 123. So by any chance, we need to find a way to deal with it. And again, at this point and this point, we have big pressure, so we need to find a way to reduce this kind of pressure to make sure that it is within a favorable or a required amount of pressure. Now, what we are going to do, as I said, we are going to introduce break pressure tank. Now, the first thing we need to do is to find a point where we want to put our break pressure tank. Okay, so from here, what we need to do is to remove this this pipe, so it is 420 and diameter is 75. So let me remove it just for now and introduce a node. Remember, this is how we are going to model our break pressure tank. And here, so from this existing node, remember this existing node, all the way to our new node, just like that, we introduce a pressure regulating valve. That's very important. Now, from this point, from this new node, again to this existing node, we need to replace back our pipe, which was 420, if I'm not mistaken, and here was 75, and here again was 140. So let's run and see what we have. Are we going to, so if we run at the final end, are we going to reduce this pressure? That's the question that we need to ask. And let me run and see. Of course, we have some errors. Now, what we need to do is to make sure that this existing node here, so this existing node elevation is the same as this new node elevation. So we need to put here 150, 180, of course, which is the same with this previous node. Now let me run again. Remember here we have 123. Let me run. Now we have 56. So from 123 all the way to 56. So that is the impact of brake pressure tank. Now the next point here again is to deal with this 124. Okay, we need to reduce it. So let me find again a way to deal with this. Again, we are going to use brake pressure tank. As I said here, we are going to do the same trick. Now here, let me delete. So this is 320. Let me delete it and introduce a new node, which is this one. So from new node to this point, I'm going to get back. Okay, I'm going to get back my deleted pipe, which was, if I'm not mistaken, 220, and here 75, and here 140. Okay, so from existing node, so from this node here, so from this node all the way to this node, I'm going to introduce pressure regulating valve just like that. Make sure that setting is zero and loss coefficient is zero. But remember, existing node elevation must be the same as new node elevation. So let me put here 120. If I'm not mistaken, here was 120. Yeah, 120. Run again. Here we have 124. Let's see if we can take this down. So from 124 all the way to 67. Okay, 124 to 67. Again, this point here, right now we have 113. Of course, as a pressure. Now we need to find a way again to take this down. So the same trick. Let me get rid of this at least for now. Then I will replace it back. So 150 as no, 550, delete. Introduce here a node, and with between the old in, or the previous node and a new one, and let me, so between the previous node and a new, we add here a pressure regulating valve. So from new node all the way to existing node, we need to replace back our deleted pipe, which was 550, and again here was diameter was 75 and coefficient of roughness, of course, 140, just like that. If we run here, as you can see here, we have a warning message, which again the same, we forgot to put elevation. So elevation here is 50, and a new node elevation, again we need to put it as a 50, just like that. So let me run again. So from 113 all the way to 46. Okay, 113 all the way to 46. Now this is the situation that we had earlier. Okay, this is, so as you can see here, this was the pressure here, and this node had a pressure of 190, and again the final destination point has had 236 as pressure, but for now we have only 56 pressure. Okay, so the idea is to show you how to model brake pressure tank in EPANET hydraulic models. Okay, so that is how it's done. So the previous situation we had this, and now we have this. So that is how a brake pressure tanks works. And that being said, I will surely see you in the next video. Thank you.